Keep your distance. What are you doing in my house? You're in Black Hall Manor. This isn't a tourist attraction. I appreciate your good taste. Come, let's talk. Good, good. People should be able to sit and have a conversation, especially in times like these. Civil discourse, the greatest of our lost arts. Wouldn't you agree? I'm glad you think so. Conversation is but one of the virtues that separate us from Cretans like those swamp folk. Swamp folk who, I should mention, absconded with a book, a precious family heirloom. I wanted to ask you, friend, will you get it back? Good. The fools who stole it believe it has powers, so the thing is probably well guarded. There's a ritual site east of the boardwalk, in the basement of a ruined house. I think you'll find it there. Bring it back to me, and be paid. I don't suppose there's any harm indulging you. What interests you? Hundreds of years, and still standing strong. You're within a fine example of Victorian architecture, my friend. Just as much as it's named after us, I suppose. We took the Black Hall name when we arrived on these shores, generations before the Great War. We do well to remember history, particularly in this dark time. What else do you want to discuss? I suppose larceny isn't enough reason to hate. You must be new here if you don't know the answer to that by now. Yes, they're dangerous. They shoot at, smash, or try to eat anything that isn't them. And half the time they shoot at each other. They may have been men once, but no more. No, not them. That lot wants for brains. But they're at least somewhat civilized. The swamp folk have no creed, no morals. They think the book has a kind of occult power. Superstition and nonsense, of course. What else do you want to discuss? Don't get yourself killed.
Wait a moment. I need to know. Has Obadiah sent you in search of a book? I thought as much. Listen to me very carefully, child. You mustn't bring it to him. That book is known as the Krivbekne, and it's a thing of evil purpose. Yes, the Krivbekne. The Blackhall family has a long, evil history with the book. It was lost to them long ago, but it's found a way back to Point Lookout, and Obadiah seeks to reclaim it. Obadiah's no better than the heathens he's asked you to steal it from. He believes he can use it to control them, and God knows what else. There's a way to destroy that damned thing. I intend to do just that. I can't promise you money, but I have some medical supplies I can share. Please, it would be a good thing you do. I ask no more. You can find me at my tent on the beach, south of Blackhall. God bless your path, child. Thank you. I attacked while I slept. I don't expect to survive. I only pray that that you haven't taken that book to Obadiah. You must take up my mission. There is one way to utterly destroy the Kryvbekhne, but you must take a pilgrimage far north of Point Lookout. In the capital wasteland, seek a place called Dunwich. Within is an obelisk, itself a wicked thing. It'll consume the book. You need only press the book to its surface. May God shed his blessings upon you, child. Make haste for Dunwich, my God. I am sorry for all my sins with all my heart, in choosing to do wrong and failing to do good. I have sinned against you, whom I shot.
Caroline Saunders speaking, Principal Geological Chemist on Fish National Gas Survey MD-16001. Preliminary results from sample site 2 are promising. We're posting similar concentrations as in the first site. Similar biogas makeup here as well, including a few organic compounds that I'm not familiar with. We've also discovered heavy lye residue in a naturally formed chamber at this excavation site. Lucky we were wearing caustics gear to begin with, or somebody might have suffered some... I'd like to analyze the site further. ...between these compounds and the lye deposit. Telling me he needs a couple of hours to work on our ventilator unit. I suppose I'll move on to Site 3 in the meantime. Further analysis is for my own curiosity, anyway. This is my authorization signature on sample Site 2. What in the world have we tapped into? Sample Site 3 is showing biogas concentration off the charts. Wetland substratum is surprisingly dense limestone at all excavation sites, and we've had no trouble locating naturally formed chambers. This and the dense calcite formation suggest that subterranean water flow has eroded a vast network of caves and grottos throughout the region. Mapping these will be a monumental effort and necessary to fully uncover the bounty of natural gas resources captured down here. What I don't understand is the amount of lye residue we're encountering. Some of my academic contacts and see if we can find any precedent for it. We'll have plenty of time to work that out, though. I've no doubt Fish will want to set up shop here and drill their little hearts out. This is Principal Geological Chemist Caroline Saunders for Fish National Gas Survey MD-16001. Consider this my authorization signature on sample site 3. Far as I'm concerned, this is a prime location for biogas harvesting and a treasure trove for some field research. This is Caroline Saunders, Principal Geological Chemist for Bish National Gas Survey MD-16001. Sample set 1 shows promising concentration of biogas in mostly limestone substratum of wetlands. No exact levels yet, but this site should exhibit more than enough extraction potential to meet survey goals. I'm going to leave a couple of interns here to handle the minutiae, but it's a formality. I'll move on to the other sites now to make sure this isn't an aberration. Consider this my authorization signature on sample site one.
Thank you.
Greetings once again, young traveler. All of Madame Panada's wares are top quality.
Good to see y'all alive, friend. I got all sorts of stuff. Take a look.
Y'all here to buy something? Look around, it's all here. Sure as a swamp folk's head is squishy.